Dry fasting is the most rapid way that you could go about losing weight when you compare it to any other form of fasting out there. And if you're someone that wants to actually get the rapid weight loss benefits from dry fasting, make sure you're someone that's not weak in the mind whatsoever, because this is only for people with a strong mindset or people that want to push for any weakness in their mind so they can get to the greatest weight loss benefits as fast as possible. And be warned, you do need to be careful with this. So if you're going to be doing this, you need to take your own safety into your own hands. So yeah, don't be worried though. As long as you do it in the most safe and effective way and you listen to me in this video on how to do it, then you can do it very safely like I do on a regular basis. It can help you get down to a very low body fat percentage and get off any excess fat. As you see, I haven't got pretty much any excess fat. Well, there's no excess fat. I've just got a healthy amount of body fat. And I have a lot of experience with intermittent dry fasting and dry fasting as a whole. And I'm currently in a soft dry fast right now, around 19 hours. So I have talked about so many times, and so many other people have, about intermittent water fasting and water fasting. But if you look into certain research out there done by a Russian scientist known as Dr. Filonov, what he discovered is that dry fasting, in comparison to water fasting, burns fat 3 times faster. Yes, you heard me, 3 times faster. And we all know, if anything can be sped up with weight loss benefits, then why would you not want to do it? Everyone wants to get them as quickly as possible. So this, from his own findings, is definitely the best type of fasting you can do to burn off fat very, very rapidly. And yeah, it's good to listen to people that are knowledgeable on what to talk about, but it's good to put things into place to see if it actually works for you and see if it rings true. And I can tell you from my own personal experience with intermittent dry fasting, which I have the most experience with, and I do this almost every single day, is it definitely works 3 times as fast, not just for weight loss, but getting me into a deeper fasted state way sooner than a water fast. I've done water fasts up to 6 days in length, and I've noticed once I get about 24 hours into a hard dry fast, that it feels that I'm 3 days into a water fast, well, the equivalent. So from my own personal experience, it makes sense to me that it works 3 times as fast for weight loss and for giving you all the other benefits that fasting gives you. A man once before, I did an experiment of doing a 24-hour hard dry fast, and 23 hours into it, I did some very intense training in quite a bit of clothing to make me sweat like crazy, and I made sure earlier in the day that I got out in the sun. I did some various other things to just burn off as much weight as I possibly could with this 24-hour dry fast, and I lost just over 10 pounds of weight within that 24 hours. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link for it up above, and I put a quick image here that shows me before and after. As you can see, I look like I've got way more water weight, my abs are not as visible, and my body's not looking nowhere near as lean and ripped. And yes, I had eaten a large meal before, so obviously not all of that weight that I lost was fat. A lot of it was obviously water weight as well, and any food that I'd eliminated out of my digestive system. But what a lot of people aren't aware of is fat is made up from fat cells. And what is fat cells mostly made up of? Water. So yes, when you are actually starting to break down your fat, you're also going to be eliminating a lot of water that is in those fat cells. So when you're eliminating water weight throughout the body, you're also going to be losing fat at the same time, at least when you're doing a dry fast to get the amazing weight loss benefits that it gives you. And I'd recommend, if you want to see someone that's getting some amazing rapid weight loss benefits with dry fasting, check out the 500-pound fasting lady that has been doing so much dry fasting, and she is losing weight like no man's business. It's crazy how much weight she is losing, and that is the main reason as to why she's losing so much weight. I'll put a link down below for a channel, and I'll show you an image of how she looks before she started doing this and after. You're not going to see her whole body, you're only going to see from just below the neck and upwards, but you also can see there's a significant difference between the two. So just give you a rough idea of how rapidly it's been working for her, and you can search up so many videos online of people that have done dry fasting for weight loss as well. So obviously, With dry fasting, the longer that you do it just with water fasting, the more rapid the weight loss benefits are going to be. It's really as simple as that. So, if you're going to do dry fasting for multiple days in a row, it's going to be way superior to intermittent dry fasting, which I said I do almost every single day. And then you've got a soft and hard dry fast, which I'll explain them quickly in this video. And I explain it way more than what I will in this video, in a video that I'll link up above. So if you want to learn more than what I talk about in this video, make sure you go check that out as well. So soft dry fast is very simple. No food intake, no liquid intake, no supplement intake, nothing intaking through your mouth and in your digestive system whatsoever. And a hard dry fast is way more hardcore. This is why it's called a hard dry fast. It's way, way, way more intense than a soft dry fast. A soft dry fast, you could go way longer for multiple days in a row with a soft dry fast than a hard dry fast. And I would personally say that a soft dry fast, when you compare it to a hard dry fast, to say a hard dry fast can work about, say, like anywhere from 30 to 50% faster for weight loss benefits and all the other benefits it will give you. And for anyone that doesn't know what a hard dry fast, it's the same as a soft dry fast, but it has the addition of coming into contact with no water. So not brushing your teeth with water, not showering, not swimming in the sea, or getting in a bath tub. It's really that simple. All you're doing is breathing in oxygen and not coming into contact with anything on your skin whatsoever. So whether you're new to intermittent fasting or you're already doing intermittent fasting but not with dry fasting combined, anyone can jump straight into doing intermittent dry fasting on a regular basis. I normally do it anywhere from 19 to 22 hours every single day. Sometimes it's a soft dry fast, sometimes it's a hard dry fast. It just varies from day to day because doing a hard dry fast every day is not always suitable because I live next to the sea and I love to swim in the sea. So I'd recommend start experimenting with this. Try soft, intermittent, dry fasting, and then just start experimenting with hard dry fasting and see how you get on with it. I found from my own experience when I started experimenting with ages ago, which I talk about in a video that I'll link up above, that it's just way, way superior to intermittent water fasting by far. And just as with intermittent water fasting, the longer that your fasting window is with intermittent dry fasting, the greater the benefits are going to be for weight loss. So the best option would be doing one meal every day, or if you're someone that's got loads of weight, you could do one meal every second day or third day or even once a week. It depends how far you want to push it. But obviously, the longer you fast for and the shorter your eating window is, the greater the benefits will be for burning fat. And then once you got used to this, you could try some longer fasts with hard dry fasting or even the soft dry fasting. So just get comfortable and knowledgeable as much as you possibly can with dry fasting and doing it for short periods of time. And then you could start trying like 36 hours, 48 hours, 72 hours, and so on. I recommend starting off with smaller amount of time of fasting and then working your way up to longer fasts and just making sure that you're being as mindful as possible. Don't push yourself too far with dry fasting, just as with water fasting, because you could get into dangerous territory. And I don't want that to happen to you, and I'm sure that you don't want to get into some territory that could be very detrimental to you. So make sure you stay as safe as you possibly can whilst doing this. And if you feel that you need to break it, just make sure that you break it. Don't let your mind just keep pushing you further where it's just not good for you to do whatsoever. But also, at the same time, there's a fine line between quitting too early when your mind's just being weak. So you've got to just be as aware as possible. Is it a good idea for me to stop? Am I just wanting to stop for some wrong reasons? Or am I needing to stop because I'm getting into a dangerous place with this? And with breaking an intermittent dry fast or even an extended dry fast, make sure you just break it with some sort of healthy liquid, whether it's some pure water or coconut water or green juice or something such as snake juice. So that is it from me in this video. If you'd like me to make any more videos talking about dry fasting, let me know down below and I'll make them for you as soon as possible. If you like the video, like it down below, give us a thumbs up. Please share this with others, leave your questions down below, and don't forget to click that subscribe button down below to receive a lot more videos from me on a regular basis. So as always, stay fit, stay energetic, and go get those gains. Peace.